Good morning, everybody. Hope you're all healthy and safe at home. So let us continue with our section on double integrals in polar coordinates. So in the previous lecture, we had seen how we can find or determine the double integrals in rectangular coordinates in terms of polar coordinates. And we had also seen an example which states that we had not solved it actually, but we had seen an example which shows the simplicity of solving a problem which is in rectangular coordinates much easier, that is in much simple way using the polar coordinates. So let's just see an example which is given in your textbook. The example is to determine the center of mass of the lamina that corresponds to the region bounded by one leaf of the rose. Okay, the region is one leaf of the rose. The rose is given by r is equal to 2 sine 2 theta in the first quadrant, and the density is at any point in the lamina is directly proportional to the distance from the pole. So you can recall that to determine the center of mass, we find two coordinates x bar and y bar, and to determine those coordinates, we have to first calculate the mass m, then we have to calculate the moments of inertia mx and capital mx and capital my. Now the formulas are double integral over r, rho xy into dA, that is the mass, and mx will be double integral over r y into rho xy, rho of x comma y into dA, and my will be double integral over r x into rho of x comma y into dA. Hope you all remember that. Now here what we are going to do is we are going to determine the value or the center of mass in terms of polar coordinates. Now if you see figure 9.9.3, you can see that they have given the one leaf of the rose which we have to consider. R is equal to 2 sine 2 theta. So if you had revised your polar coordinates and the graphing of polar functions or forms, you can, this is much clearer and easy. So this is this figure that or the lamina that we have to consider. Now we need to know what is the density value, density function, that is rho of x comma y. So here we have to see what will be the value rho of, instead of rho of x comma y, we will determine rho of r comma theta. If rho of x comma y is given to us, we will convert x into x and y in terms of r and theta. So here it is given that the density at a point P is in the lamina is directly proportional to the distance from the pole. So here we know the pole we are considering is always the origin or the center O. So the density is directly proportional to the distance from the pole. Now if you recall that any graph or any point in polar which we are plotting, we consider this angle to be theta and this line is the distance r, right? So here also our rho of xy will be, or the distance from the pole to the point P will be nothing but modulus of r. It can be positive or negative. So since it is a distance, we take it only the positive values, that is mod. So here rho of r comma theta is nothing but k into r. It is a proportional. They are saying that it is not equal to r, but it is proportional. So it will be some constant into the distance. So we have got our density function, that is rho of r comma theta is nothing but k into modulus of r. Now next, to complete or to determine this integral, we need to find the variation of theta and variation of r. Variation of r is direct, it varies from 0 to 2 sine 2 theta. And now from the figure, it is clear that theta varies from 0, the angle is 0 to pi by 2. So theta is varying from 0 to pi by 2, and r is varying from 0 to 2 sine 2 theta, and we have our density function also, rho of r comma theta is equal to k into modulus r. Now we'll substitute these values and we can find mass m. M will be double integral over r k into mod r into dA. Now we'll substitute the value, k is a constant, we can take it out common, and it will be 0 pi by 2, 0 to pi by 2, r varies 0 to pi by 2, and theta varies from 0 to pi by 2, and r varies from 0 to 2 sine 2 theta, and we have r we are taking only the positive value r, and dA is replaced by r into dr into d theta. So don't forget this r over here. So it is r square. So the integral with respect to r will be r cube by 3, and we are substituting it the values. So we'll get 2 sine cube 2 theta, 2 cube into sine cube 2 theta. 2 cube is 8, 8 by 3 is taken out common. So this will be sine cube 2 theta. Now what we are going to do is we'll take one sine out common, that is the remaining will be sine square 2 theta, and sine square 2 theta is replaced by 1 minus cos square 2 theta. Okay, so here what we'll do is, now if we multiply or open the bracket, the first term will be sine 2 theta, and the second term will be minus cos square 2 theta into sine 2 theta. So the second term integration can be done by the process of substitution. If you put u is equal to cos 2 theta, then du will be nothing but minus sine 2 theta d theta. So sine 2 theta will get cancelled, and the we will have the integral of u square or cos square 2 theta. So u square will be nothing but u cube by 3. So that will be cos cube 2 theta by 3. And from where did this 6 come? Remember, there is a constant for 2 theta, so that 2 will come in the denominator, so it will be 1 by 6 cos cube 2 theta. And the first one integral is simple, integral of sine 2 theta is nothing but minus cos 2 theta by 2. And then by applying the limits, you will get the value to be 16 by 9 k. So I hope the valuation of the mass is clear. Now next we will move on to the moment of inertia. So first here they are determining the moment of inertia with respect to the y-axis. So my will be nothing but k into double integral over rx into r into dA. So we'll change everything in terms of r and d theta. So the variation of theta is from 0 to pi by 2 again, and r is from 0 to 2 sine 2 theta. Then we have 1r here, and 1r will be of dA. dA will be r into dr into d theta. And what will be the value of x? X is nothing but r cos theta in terms of polar coordinates. So we'll have r cube into cos theta into dr d theta. So the integral with respect to r will be r raised to 4 by 4 into cos theta. Now we'll substitute the value of r. 4 can be taken out common, and when we take 2 raised to 4 will be nothing but 4 to 8, 8 to 16. So 16 by 4 is nothing but 4. So that's how this 4 has come out common. And then we have sine raised to 4 2 theta into cos theta d theta. So here what we are going to do is we will use the formula of sine 2 theta. Now what is sine 2 theta? Sine 2 theta is 2 sine theta cos theta. So what will be the power raised to 4? It will be 16 sine raised to 4 theta cos raised to 4 theta. Okay, we are applying sine 2 theta, formula of sine 2 theta. We are expanding sine 2 theta and taking it to the power 4. Now when we substitute this, or what you can see is here, it will be, the value will be 16 can be taken out common. So 64k into sine raised to 4 theta into cos raised to 5 theta. Okay, here what we are doing is we'll take 1 cos theta out common. So what will be the remaining? Cos raised to 4 theta, right? Or we can substitute the value of cos raised to 4 theta by 1 minus sine square theta whole square theta, correct? 1 minus sine square theta is cos square theta, whole square will be again cos raised to 4 theta. So then what we do is we expand it. So this is how we can solve it in a easier way, in a very simple manner. That is, when we expand it by a minus b whole square formula and multiplying it by sine raised to 4 theta, it will be 1 minus 2 sine raised to 4 theta plus sine raised to 4 theta. So when we multiply it by sine raised to 4 theta, it will be sine raised to 4 theta minus 2 sine raised to 6 theta plus sine raised to 8 theta into cos theta. Now if you ask why did we leave behind, or why did we just separate 1 cos theta out common, now if you see, if you open the bracket, we'll have the terms. What will be the terms in the integral? It will be sine raised to 4 theta minus into cos theta minus 2 sine raised to 6 theta into cos theta plus sine raised to 8 theta into cos theta. So here how can we find the, or how can we evaluate this integral? Everything, every term is the power of sine and cos, and there is multiple product of sorry the product of sine and cos, and there is powers for sine. So we will use the substitution method, and we will substitute the value, say u is equal to sine raised sine theta, then du will be nothing but minus cos theta d theta. So we will substitute the value, so everything will be easier. The evaluation will be like, you will have to integrate u raised to 4 minus u raised to 6 plus the coefficients are there plus u raised to 8. So that will be nothing but sine raised to 5 theta by 5 minus 2 by 7 into sine raised to 7 theta plus 1 by 9 into sine raised to 9 theta varying from 0 to pi by 2. And the value will be nothing but 512 by 315 into k. This we can evaluate easy because the limiting values are easy, because sine 0 is always 0 and sine pi by 2 is 1. So I hope the integration concept is clear. We are taking out this term common to make the integration much more easier. So what you can do is, you can just practice out how to use or how to determine the value of mx. There is a hint, or the value is already given to you, that is, it is same as my. So once we know the value of mx and my, we can easily determine the coordinates of the center of mass. So mx will be nothing but k integral 0 to pi by 2 integral 0 to 2 sine theta into r cube into it, there it was x, right? Here it will be y, and y is r sine theta. So r cube sine theta dr d theta. So just do this integration again step by step. You will find the value of mx to be 512 by 315 by k itself. So you can just work that out by yourself. So then from those two values, we can determine the value or the coordinates of the center of mass, that is x bar equal to y bar will be equal to 512 k by 315 whole divided by the mass, that is 16 k by 9, that is nothing but 32 by 35. So in this manner we can easily determine the center of mass of a given lamina to us. If we consider the coordinates, if the same shape, or if we consider same lamina and if we try to do it with respect to rectangular coordinates, it will be pretty much difficult. So so just I want all of you to just try out or work out with the my part, the moment of inertia with along the x axis, and try to do the integration part, which will make the concept more clearer to you. So with this, we shall wind up today's session. Thank you. Stay home and stay safe.